motherfucking loud spot.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the loud spot. I say everybody like there's like a whole bunch of motherfuckers watching us or listening.
There is a bunch of motherfuckers watching us.
I'm hanging out with Don, and it's been a long time since we've had Canada Rob on the show. He is back with us after many months of not being on, but we have been very busy. And Rob, how have you been, man? Long time.
I'm doing awesome, man. Thank you for having me back on the show. It's a pleasure to be with you, beautiful face, and you.
I say long time, but I talk to him outside the podcast also, so not too long of a time.
I don't get to say no. Hi, Rob.
Yeah, you never get to see him. So here's what I want to say. So this has been bugging me, and I'm going to put it out there. Not that anyone's going to fucking listen, but it really irritates me when we have people that come on the show. We're not going to mention names. Okay, we're not mentioning names. But earlier time we were supposed to have a show, and when people know they have a podcast to do, I don't care if you're like the smallest podcaster or the biggest podcaster. Be prepared to be on a podcast. Don't be out in the middle of downtown wherever, walking around, not paying attention. Because what happened? I had to cut the podcast short. I said, you know what? I'm not dealing with it today.
Well, it's not just that. And we've had several people that are like driving down the road. And we're like, well, we can't see you. What the hell? Y'all, if you come on a podcast, we love you guys. We respect you guys. We appreciate you guys for coming on. However, please show us the same respect. Show up like you give a damn, because we do.
It's disrespectful, you know? If you're not going to, like, be involved in the podcast, then why be there, right?
Like, yeah. And don't make us feel like you didn't want to really be here. You just showed up because you felt you was obligated.
Well, quality is what we want, right? And so we strive for quality. We've done a lot of things to make the show better. And it makes them look bad, too. And then they're like, you know, then they get, well, no one watched my episode. Well, look at how you came on. Like, you could be interesting and an interesting person. And people could really like you, a band, actor, whatever you are. But what it comes down to is if it's a horrible, because, you know, we're on YouTube also, right? And so the YouTube video is going to look crappy because you're going to tell that you didn't want to be there. And the audio, when you're out and about, like, I had a band that was on, I had to redo the whole entire thing one time because the one guy was at a baseball park at a baseball game. And he's like, oh,
yeah, it's difficult.
He's walking away from the crowd. I'm like, dude, you can still like hear that you're somewhere. But then the audio sucks because then the Wi-Fi is horrible. It starts crackling. So you're doing yourself a disjustice to yourself, your fans, and my show that we're doing here. Don and I work very hard to make sure that we try to conduct really good interviews with whoever comes on the show. It makes it difficult when they're half-assed paying attention and they don't want to be here anyways and give one-word answers. That's not what we want, and we do not like that. So if you're ever going to be on the show and you watch it, I'm going to start cutting these fucking movies short. I am. I'm going to start, you know what, I'm not even going to do them. But sometimes, you know, I feel like we should still attempt to do it because sometimes it still winds up sounding okay.
Yeah. But I mean, it's just a mutual respect thing. We're honored to have you on the show. You know, show the same respect. I mean, but then again, I'm sitting here talking shit and I'm smoking a fucking cigarette. So.
And Rob's microphone's not working right. at least we're all home, you know.
Get your hair, and you guys have misfits, and then like you have this beautiful face beside you, and like the music background behind her.
That's the second time you've made me blush tonight, Rob.
Well, that's what I try and do. I try and pump you guys up.
You're awesome. Thank you. And just for the record, I always ask any band before they come on, do you mind if I smoke? Do you mind if we're having a drink or something? We always do ask. We try to be considerate of everyone.
Yeah, and I ask, you know, if they mind if I swear, because sometimes I swear. You know, if you go, mm-hmm. you know, it is what it is. I just want people to respect not only my show, but everyone else's show. We may just be little small-time podcasters. But if you're doing-
But you don't want to stay small. No. You don't want to stay small. You want to up, you know, progress and up your game and up your shit. And
but they
want people to care and you care. And
famous, and when you're famous.
Yeah, what? There you go.
Yeah.
I'm trying to switch my camera around here. I got my podcast equipment. I'm not all professional like you guys, but
Dude, I got like a $10 ring light and
my $10 ring light behind me. I don't even turn that motherfucker on. Like, it just
I've got a fucking bearded dragon behind me.
Oh, guys, like seriously, I have like $300 invested in my stuff. Mm-hmm. I figure this, or when you guys call on me, I can come on here and be like, plug my shit in, and here we are.
We're good. There you go. It just takes playing around with it. I've had to play around with mine, taking it on the road with me lately to venues. And it takes some adjusting. But, you know, once you get it down, you get used to it, pack it up in a bag. Let's go.
Last thing I want to mention, because I'm still fucking butthurt. Last thing I want to mention is you're doing yourself a disjustice by not being professional. Mm-hmm. Your fans are going to be like, oh, this guy's cool, but now he looks like a douchebag or she or, you know, whatever. So come correct. Last thing I also want, one more thing is, if you're coming on the show and you're going to be on your phone, have headphones on, because otherwise it makes, sometimes it just makes the it makes a popping sound and just doesn't sound good. So if you're coming on my show or anyone's show and you're watching this, if you're going to be on your cell phone, that's fine. Try to be with good Wi-Fi and have headphones and make sure your phone's charged. Because we play a lot of music videos and we're trying to represent your band and make you look good. So make yourself look good.
And read the email, because the email has all of that information on there when we send them out to everybody for booking.
Sometimes they don't. No, it depends on who we book to. Like certain people, I don't know if their agent tells them.
Oh.
I've mentioned it. But right. I don't, because I a lot of times I don't know the band's email. Like I don't contact the bands.
Well, maybe it'd be a good idea to send that particular email to whoever's booking and have them forward it to every band. Yeah,
that's a good idea.
Because a lot of bands don't know the proper etiquette for going on a podcast, and it's helpful.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Still waiting for Drury to come up here.
What?
Still waiting for Drury.
Who's that?
Drury.
Who's Drury?
Dury?
D-U-R-Y.
Oh, Dury, the band Dury.
Yeah.
They're good. They were supposed to come. Yeah, they were supposed to come on the show. They canceled. That was a while ago, man.
That was a couple months ago.
That was a while ago.
Way longer than a couple months ago. I feel like it was like a year ago.
Was it?
It's been
time flies. Speaking of time, cheers to my 1 year anniversary with the Loud Spot.
Hey, cheers. That's right. Mm-hmm. What day's today?
We're almost a week late on it, but it was our first podcast after that together.
The 14th, August 14th. So this is going to air actually the 15th, but on the 14th will be my 1 year anniversary or 2 year anniversary of podcasting.
Nice.
1 year of you being on the show. So,
hi.
All right. And
thank you.
That means Rob's been on the show. Let's see. Were you on the show before Don came on as a co-host? Or no, afterwards.
Don was just starting off as a co-host.
Okay, yeah.
So I met you guys probably around the same time, I guess.
Saw you on TikTok.
On TikTok. Hey, man, I've almost got like 12,000 followers on TikTok.
Right.
No, dude, you keep on going viral.
I know. I put a video today, and it's like literally skyrocketing. I can't even believe how many videos that are like.
Because all the girls think he's
congratulations.
Sexy. All the girls think he's sexy because he's like that silver fox and he's Canadian. So
you're talking like I'm one of those people that go on a live and I like take off my shirt and do stuff.
He's got that light on there. It makes his eyes all glowy and pretty.
It's the
blue eyes. Yeah.
Girls. Let me hear for a second.
I need contacts.
I need contacts.
I'm gonna get blue eye contacts. Maybe I'll get my TikTok to grow.
Hi.
There's
Dawn. Hey.
Hello. How are you?
Hey, you guys move up to the camera. Show me your eyes.
They got blue eyes too. Oh yeah, I can't.
My turn.
You don't know which way the camera's gonna go.
Your eyes are bloodshot.
Kids telling on you. You got busted, bro.
Caught out.
You got busted. All right. I want to move on to Horror Con, what we did with at Oklahoma City Horror Con. That was really fun.
Yeah.
I got to talk to Lou Ferrigno, who plays the Incredible Hulk. He's also on King of Queens. He was also like Mr. Universe, and I think that's everything. Super nice guy. But he's like a hero. Not really. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't consider him with horror, but because he is a green monster, I guess, mm-hmm. made sense for him to be there. So that was really fun. And it was just such a good time. I got to talk to anyone who watches American Horror Story, the lady who plays.
For a second.
Yeah. What's up?
Lou Ferrigno.
That's what I talked about. Lou Ferrigno. I said it.
Yeah. So when I was a kid, 1980 something. Okay. So we'd have dinner and then go hide because the Hulk.
What
scared you
on the TV? My dad would sit in the after supper. Mom's mm-hmm. doing dishes. My dad's sitting on the couch. I'm playing. My sisters are doing something else. And as soon as I hear the Hulk theme song come on, I hid.
Were you just scared?
No lie. I hid. Rigno come through the door. I'm out of here. Done.
Out. Deuces.
I'm crying. No. I'm in tears.
Really?
Absolutely.
What scared you about him? What was so terrifying about him?
He was green and big, and the song kind of scared me.
I never really? Even seen it. I'm not going to lie. I never seen the Hulk on TV.
I was young.
Yeah. I never saw. I never even seen it.
The girls,
you didn't?
That's
blasphemous.
Yeah, but the thing is, see, I didn't watch it because my parents didn't really watch stuff like that. My mom, my mom's deaf.
Mm-hmm.
So we didn't watch. I mean, we did watch a lot of TV still, but my dad pretty much turned on sitcoms or the Spanish channel a lot of times.
Mm-hmm.
I just didn't. There was a lot of stuff that I just didn't see as a kid. Like, we watched stuff. Yeah. It was different things, just a little bit different. So I didn't watch. Plus, I was when what year was the Hulk? What years was that a big thing? Late 80s?
I don't know, but I'm
not. I don't know either. But I'm saying
I'm too old for this shit.
I didn't watch it. You know these things.
Hey,
1982, 1983. I was born in 82, so I would have been 1 year old or two.
Mm-hmm.
So anyways, I got to talk to the lady who plays Pepper from American Horror Story. She was super cool. And then from Halloween 5, which came out 33 years ago.
Oh, wow.
I know. I didn't realize that it was that. And that's Halloween 5.
Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
Shut up, Smash.
What was that, Rob?
1995?
Wait, what was I talking about? No, Sam.
Pepper.
Yeah. No, then I was talking about Halloween 5, which came out 3 years ago. So 30 years ago was, I don't know what year that was, but whatever 30 years ago was.
I graduated high school.
We're so stupid.
All right. I want to hear, and then there's this song. I never heard that band Bad Omens before. So
I cannot believe you have not heard of it. It's been all, I see how much attention you be paying to me because I've been playing that shit all the time, posting it all the time.
I never don't worry. I don't pay attention to myself.
That's fucked up.
I even forgot what I was talking about a little bit ago. Okay, let's check out this song. We're going to do a little interlude and play this jam. And then we're going to talk about what Don, what you did just the last week or the weekend before. And then we're coming up, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's check out this song. It is called Bad Omens, The Death of Peace of Mind. Here we go. And it's not a video. We're just going to sit here and look stupid and watch this. Okay, here we go.
Sounds good. I already look dumb.
I miss the way you say my name, the way you bend, the way you
Fucking told you. See, this is why I like talking about music. You get introduced to shit you didn't know you liked.
Yeah, I mean, my playlist, no joke. That is a dope ass song.
The whole album is like that. Listen to it. Just go ahead and download most of the shit because you're gonna like all of it.
Okay. Yeah, you know what? I like it, and I think it's very cool. I like the ending there. It gets hard. And he starts screaming.
Uh huh. Not expecting that.
I've been sleeping on these dudes, man. I've been sleeping on them. Rob, what'd you think?
It's the first time I've ever heard them. So
really?
I need to know. Yeah, absolutely.
Bad Omens, Death of Peace of Mind. He's going to play like a villain, I think, as well.
You're going to have to
text damn
me.
Good.
And I'll listen to it. No, I really like it. It's great.
Yeah. I'm
a good beat.
Yeah.
The lyrics are pretty strong, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
His vocals go to that very gentle, just flowy, and then he can just thoroughly and smoothly ease off into the just the growls, and I feel that shit. I like it.
Yeah. I'm going to have to check out it on YouTube, too.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah. Let's talk about bars in Canada. No one goes to the bars in Canada, huh? Eh? No one goes to the bars in Canada.
Hey.
Not where I am, anyway.
Because of COVID? They
go, well, no, they found something else to do.
Yeah.
I haven't been to a bar in, 3 years.
Really?
I go and check out venues with bands and stuff like that. Does that make sense?
Well, no. Absolutely you would, though, right? But nobody, there's no bands playing in Canada, I don't think.
Oh, I hate that. That sucks.
How many guys have you interviewed? How many of them have Canadian tour dates? Ask them that.
You know what? I don't really pay attention that much. I do, but I guess most of the bands that come on here aren't doing that. They're just not. I never thought about it. I never thought, why don't you go to Canada? What the fuck's wrong with you?
Yeah.
That's all I think about it. You know, I'm like, oh, you're going.
For us to start asking, like you said, you know, what's up with not going to Canada?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, I barely heard what you said. You cut out. What'd you say?
Things are opening up here.
Open they up. Are?
Well, they've been open up here.
Good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, no, for a long time. Sebastian, you've told me that many times. I don't know. We can do whatever we want.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to HorrorCon. And like I said, I thought I was going to get COVID because it was like a bunch of motherfuckers there. There was like, I mean, a lot of people there. And I was like kind of worried, but it's been a week now and I'm good. So I don't think I wind up getting it there. Okay, Don, you have some things. First, let's talk about what you did last weekend?
Let's do the week before. Let's do it in chronological.
Yeah, do that. Tell us what you did.
Well, I went to Purgatory Entertainment's launch party in Houston, Texas. I met up with the guys at with Saturate, Awaken the Giant. We watched so many bands play. The launch party was incredible. Widow 7 and The Crown, you guys really need to check them out too if you haven't. Fantastic bands. I really enjoyed. Everybody was so, okay. This was my first time going to Texas, period. Much less fucking Houston. Okay. Bitch was intimidated. Okay. I was intimidated. The traffic, small town Alabama country girl gets in Houston, Texas traffic. I'm tripping. You hear me? Anyway, got to the venue and everybody was so fucking warm and welcoming. And this, it was incredible because everybody just makes you feel like you're part of the family when you go in. And like I said, the bands were just Saturate. Jesus, man, what a fucking show. You guys can go on to the Loud Spot Cruise page, Southern Flame page. You can go to Purgatory Entertainment page. The Sound 228 also did coverage there. It was just absolutely incredible. There's lots of media coverage from so many people.
Your pictures look fun. Like, look like you had a really good time hanging out.
I do. You know, and I'm not a professional photographer by no means at all, but I love taking pictures and making memories, and that's just what I do. I go and I visit with the bands, and I just kind of get to know everyone and see them in their element and then listen to them play. I try to capture moments for myself and for everyone else of the experience and just kind of get everybody's name out there while doing something that I enjoy.
I'm going to ask you a question. I know you're not going to answer, but that's okay.
I will answer.
We'll see.
She'll answer.
Was there any bands that you were disappointed in that sound good, but had a horrible live show?
No, there was not. Every single one of them that was up there was phenomenal.
That's awesome.
I was so impressed.
That makes it work.
Okay, and Awaken the Giant also had a stand-in singer that I think is, I'm not sure. I don't know if that was his first or maybe second show he did with them. And I was blown away at, it was powerful to see such a transition. His name is Jesse Sawyer.
Okay.
He was previously from Rise the Phoenix. I was completely blown away and I was so amazed. And these are all people that I've been talking to and I've bonded with and I think, you know, made connections with. I mean, get to meet so many people in person, you know, and it's overwhelmingly emotional and it's a beautiful experience. And to see them in their element doing what they love, yeah, it's a beautiful experience.
Bob, do you have something to say?
Nope.
You raised your finger. You raised your finger earlier.
I'm sorry.
No. Can you hear me? No?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Can you hear us?
Oh, I can hear you loud and clear now. I'm trying to adjust the camera.
Yeah, I thought I adjusted the camera. Okay.
I'm sorry, guys.
That's okay. We're going to wrap this up. I know Dawn is going to.
No. Stay for a few more minutes with me because I want to talk about last weekend and the upcoming event, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, talk about the upcoming event. And then okay. I want to play because, you know, the radio stations, those internet ones play our 30-minute show.
I'll make this really quick. Okay. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. I went to the Cannery Bar and Grill in Biloxi last weekend. I think it was last weekend. Yeah, it was last weekend. And we saw so many bands play again from Awaken the Giant and Kingdom Collapse.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they were so good. There's lots of media coverage on there from the sound. And I got personal photos as well and videos. So y'all go check those out. And we have an event coming up in Biloxi August 20th. That is, I think the doors open at 5 p.m. And that is also going to be at the Cannery Bar and Grill. And that one is a fundraiser for Make-A-Wish of Mississippi.
Cool.
And there's Envision's going to be there, Saturate, Awaken the Giant, Relevant Saints, Project 9, and more. There's going to be so many more. It is sponsored and promoted and everything It's put together by Massive Media Productions, and the sound 228, the pit is sponsoring.
The Loud Spot, they always tag us in post.
Well, I'm there. I'm going to be there representing the Loud Spot.
Awesome.
Yeah, I'm going to be there. So you guys come out, say hi. If you want hugs, come give hugs. I'm easy to talk to. You guys come say hi.
Absolutely.
Your entry into the venue is a donation to Make-A-Wish of Mississippi. So cool.
And seriously, go if you're down there. Dawn's going to be representing the Loud Spot, and she is very easy to talk to. Go say hi, and she'll talk with you. I know that. So, all right. Let's close this out with another song from Bad Omens, Like a Villain, right?
Let's do it.
All right, let's check it out.
Thanks,
let's
guys.
And then after this song, from the outro, we'll be done. But guys, stay right there till after the recording. Peace out. Rock on.
Much love.
Much love.
This is the Loud Spot outro by Nothing Short of Tragic.
Is this all talk with no action?
No.
Is this my thoughts with distraction?
No.
Is this what I bought that's in fashion? Or is this the Loud Spot with Sebastian?
Yes.
Does Nothing Short of Tragic have his back again?
Yes.
Does anything that's good really have to end?
Yes.
Our pimp host has to pimp show, so to get more episodes, make an order, this is over.